массовой информации.
The British police. He's the prime suspect in the killing of former Russian agent Alexander Litvinenko. But back home in Russia, he's set to become a TV star.
Впервые в качестве ведущего Андрей Луговой.
From today, Andrei Lugovoy has his own series. It's called Traitors, all about Soviet citizens who betrayed the motherland for the West. Mr. Lugovoy denies murder, and Moscow has refused to extradite him to the UK.
Предатели не актуальны во все времена.
Treachery is always a topical subject, not just for Russia, but for Britain and America too. We know that you had your own traitors that worked for USSR or for Russia. As long as there is confrontation between us, there will always be traitors.
Russia's president seems to think so. Last month, live on TV, Vladimir Putin announced that there were people in Russia prepared to betray their country's national interests. The Kremlin has also warned of a fifth column threatening Russia from the inside. State-controlled media have been employing the phrase national traitors. But why?
With Russia under increasing pressure from sanctions and increasingly isolated from the West, the temptation for the authorities here is to look for traitors and turncoats and fifth columnists. In other words, to seek out the enemy within, to deflect criticism at home.
History teacher Tamara Edelman has been a vocal critic of Russia's intervention in Ukraine. But she was astonished to find herself portrayed on national TV recently as a traitor, along with several pop stars and politicians.
It's much easier to rule when you have enemies and everybody can unite against these enemies. And you can always explain that prices are rising and shops are getting empty and so many terrible things happen because of these enemies.
Tamara concedes that Putin's Russia is not Stalin's Russia, where enemies of the people were sent to the gulag. But criticism here is still equated with treachery, and Russia is still searching for scapegoats. Steve Rosenberg, BBC News, Moscow.